digital can be better.
So let me ask a question, and I ask this of everybody I have on the show. Is it possible that we can find a way to make banking kind of badass or more badass, or is it hopeless? Is it simply a utility that'll never be decommoditized?
No, I think there's a lot of interesting things going on in this space. So this core banking is it's zeros and ones. It's moving digits around. So with a lot of banking, it is commoditized, but there's a lot of innovation going on the edges in the experience. And there's a lot of community FIs who are investing in that and looking to bring some of these innovative solutions to their customers, to their members, because again, they have the relationships. And there are dozens of these really cool and interesting fintech innovations out there. A lot of them are starting in a B2C model.
Right.
And most of them realize pretty quickly that cost of acquisition is really high.
That's how we started at GZO. You know, it was a B2C.com.
Yep, GZO. That's right. I remember that very well. Yep. You guys, Jwala, Yodlee, yep. And every single one of those companies pivoted from the B2C model. So it's almost like a lot of the ones that are starting today, they don't do the research or check the history books to figure out, GZO started B2C, Jwala started B2C, right. Yodlee started B2C. Oh, they all ended up going B2B.
I think there's something sexy about the whole B2C thing, right? Maybe it's heralding back to the late 90s, the whole .com. You know, working with the banks and the credit unions or the cores directly may not appear as sexy. It might be a lot sexier to try to be a mint.com to some of these, especially these PFM companies.
Well, it's so capital intensive. And at the end of the day, the cost of acquisition for a B2C and a consumer in the banking space is very high.
Yeah.
You look at how much money Chime has raised. Chime has raised a tremendous amount of money because it's so capital intensive to acquire customers that the community banks and credit unions, they hold the relationships.
Yep.
So, in theory, it's a really great idea because it is a lower cost of acquisition if they were able to bundle these services and, yes, bring badass, cool, innovative solutions to their customers. But the gap in that process that we are looking to fill is those community institutions aren't used to bringing these new innovative products to their customers.
Right.
We talk to a lot, you mentioned Strategy Core. They've got really innovative things. But a lot of institutions will speak to, like, this is the first product new product they rolled out in years.
In decades.
So it's not in their, sort of DNA yet to engage with those members and bring those new services to them.
Yep.
That's where engagement as a service or onboarding as a service comes into play.
Yep.
So if you've got, we're working with a number of these individual innovative companies who are, who would like to partner with a bank or partner with a credit union to bring those services to their customers as, now you're going to need to promote that. We've got you. Engagement, onboarding as a service, hit this button, and all the best content, messages, outreach is ready to go for that innovative service to your customers.
Yep, and that's the way to do it. That sounds like engagement banking to me. So aside from digital, name a bank or credit union or even a bank or a fintech that you really admire.
I want to say DCU, and I'll tell you why the reason is, and I know that a number of other institutions are doing similar things or would like to do similar things, but I think if you look at what DCU has done with their FinTech Innovation Center.
Yeah, the lab concept.
Yeah. And they were really on the forefront of this, and they took their community charter at heart, which was to support innovation and within, particularly fintech innovation within their community. So, really an altruistic part of their charter, and they would provide space, and really it was just, we want to help and get these brilliant minds together. They may have nothing to do with our credit union. We'll never use this service. It's not relevant. It's a blockchain thing. So I really admire that about what they've done. how they've interpreted their charter to serve their community to help that. And that's actually where our platform came out of. And our whole concept and learning and getting deeply engaged with the challenges that banking and credit union, community banking and credit union executives are facing, so that we could really understand how we as technology providers could help serve, you know, them better.
Gotcha.
And without that sort of collaboration that they've put together, we wouldn't be doing what we're doing. We wouldn't be having the success that we're seeing.
Yep.
No, so I think that I really admire them, and I know that a lot of credit unions